We go to Winchester Cathedral for today's broadcast of Choral Evensong. The Canticles are sung to the setting in A-flat by Edmund Rubbra, and the Anthem, with music by William Harris, is Strengthen Ye the Weak Hands. The service opens with Edward Bairstow's setting of the hymn taken from the Liturgy of St. James, Let All Mortal Flesh Keep Silence.
To the Father and to the Son and brings now the psalms appointed for the 10th evening of the month, beginning with Psalm 53.
Thank you. book Genesis chapter 18, which is the first lesson for the eve of the Feast of St. Benedict. And the Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre, as he sat at the door of his tent in the heat of the day. He lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, three men stood in front of him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them, and bowed himself to the earth and said, "My Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree, while I fetch a morsel of bread, that you may refresh yourselves. And after that, you may pass on, since you have come to your servant." So they said, "Do as you have said." And Abraham hastened into the tent to Sarah and said, "Make ready three measures of fine meal, knead it, and make cakes." And Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to the servant, who hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf which he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. Here ends the first lesson.
Oh, The first letter of Peter, chapter 4, beginning at verse 7. The end of all things is at hand. Therefore, keep sane and sober for your prayers. Above all, hold unfailing your love for one another, since love covers a multitude of sins. Practice hospitality ungrudgingly to one another. As each has received a gift, employ it for one another as good stewards of God's varied grace. Whoever speaks, as one who utters oracles of God. Whoever renders service, as one who renders it by the strength which God supplies, in order that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. To him belong glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal which comes upon you to prove you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice in so far as you share Christ's sufferings, that you may also rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed. If you are reproached for the name of Christ, you are blessed, because the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon
upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And grant it for
ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people. Give peace in our time, O Lord.
People's hell is the love that ruleth the world, but only the God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us. Let us pray. O God, by whose grace the blessed Abbot Benedict, enkindled with the fire of thy love, became a burning and a shining light in thy church, grant that we may be inflamed with the same spirit of discipline and love, and ever walk before thee as children of light, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth, one God, world without end.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be said to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
God bless this cathedral church, the Diocese of Winchester, all members of the Order of St. Benedict, living and departed, and the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
The anthem is Strengthen Ye the Weak Hands by William Harris, beginning with the words, "The Lord hath created medicines out of the earth." our prayers for the Anglican Communion, we remember the church in the southern cone of America, and in particular the Diocese of Peru with Bolivia, its Bishop Alan Winstanley, and also the Diocese of Chile with its Bishop Colin Baisley, who is also the presiding bishop. In our prayers for the clergy and people of this Winchester Diocese, we pray for the parish of Westbourne, Bournemouth, its minister Brian Ruff, and also for a parish in the gift of the Dean and Chapter, Wunston and Stoke Charity with Hunton, the parish priest Anthony Jardine, and Robert Clarkson, the non-stipendiary minister. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty and everlasting God, who alone workest great marvels, send down upon our bishops and clergy and all congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of thy grace, and that they may truly please thee, pour upon them the continual dew of thy blessing. Grant this, O Lord, for the honor of our advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ. We pray also for this cathedral church, giving thanks at this time for the 5.5 centuries when there was a Benedictine monastery here. We pray that we may ever share St. Benedict's devotion to the Psalms of David and be faithful to his ideals of ordered daily worship, work, and hospitality. We pray for all members of the foundation and congregation, for the friends of the cathedral celebrating in this month their Diamond Jubilee, for all the other voluntary helpers and all who visit the cathedral, especially those whom we welcome to this service. O God of our fathers, who of old didst move thy servants in this place to build an house of prayer for the offering of eternal praises to thy glorious majesty, grant to us and to all who herein call upon thy holy name from age to age, that by the offering of our lives and the praises of our lips, we may ever seek the increase of thy glory and thy kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And a prayer for the needs of the world, especially for those poorer countries stricken with famine, disease, and malnutrition, for their many, many children. And we ask for God's blessing on the work of the great charities and on all agencies seeking to relieve misery. O God, by whose power alone the human race is enabled to live together in harmony and concord, in health and safety, look upon the broken body of humanity and grant that wherever men meet in council for the ordering of the world, thy Holy Spirit may bring them into unity and lead them in the ways of peace and justice, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And on the eve of his feast day, a prayer written by St. Benedict. O gracious and holy Father, give us wisdom to perceive thee, diligence to seek thee, patience to wait for thee, eyes to behold thee, a heart to meditate upon thee, and a life to proclaim thee through the power of the Spirit of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Finally, praying for each other and for ourselves, we say all together the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen.
Thank you.
Hubert Parry's Fantasia and Fugue in G, ending our broadcast of Choral Evensong direct from Winchester Cathedral. The choir was conducted by the organist and master of the choristers, David Hill. The organ was played by the assistant organist, Timothy Byram-Wigfield.